Hello students, today we shall start your 8th chapter of science, wind storm and cyclone. Odisha was hit by a cyclone with wind speed of 200 km per hour on October 18, 1999. On October 29, in the same year, a second cyclone with wind speed of 260 km per hour hit Odisha again. It was accompanied by water waves about 9 meter high. But what are cyclones? How are they formed? Why are they so destructive? In this chapter, we will seek answer to some of these questions. We begin with some activities involving air. These activities will clarify some basic features concerning a cyclone. Before we begin, remember that the moving air is called the wind. Now, there are two figures which shows that air exert pressure. In the first figure, a boy is using a bottle in which this is the empty bottle and the material required for this activity, empty bottle and a piece of paper. Now, crumble a small piece of paper into a ball of size smaller than the mouth of an empty bottle. Second, hold the empty bottle on its side and place the paper ball just inside the mouth. Place the paper ball just inside its mouth. Now blow on the ball to force it into the bottle. Repeat the activity with bottle of different sizes. What you will observe, it is difficult to force the paper ball into the bottle. What is the reason behind it? Then the reason is, when we blow into the mouth of the bottle, the air near the mouth has higher speed. The air near the mouth has higher speed. This decreases the pressure there. The air pressure inside the bottle is higher than near the mouth. The air inside the bottle pushes the ball out. It shows that air exerts pressure. In second activity, here a tin can with an airtight lid, water, burner and tong. Take a tin can with a lid. Here we will take a tin can with a lid. Fill it approximately half with water. Heat the water in the tin can without its lid. Let the water boil. Using a stand, remove the tin can from the flame. Immediately close the mouth of the tin can tightly. Place it in a sink. Pour cold water over it. What is the conclusion of this experiment? The tin can is half filled with water and half filled with air. When the tin is heated, most of the air in the tin is pushed out in the form of steam. When the tin can is closed and is cooled down, the steam condenses to form water, thus reduces the amount of air inside. The pressure of the air on the outside is more than the inside. So the tin can gets crumbled. This shows that air exert pressure. Now, next point is, wind current are generated due to uneven heating on the earth. Uneven heating between the equator and the poles. You might have learned in geography that region close to equator get maximum heat from the sun. The air in this region gets warm. The warm air rises and the cooler air from the region in the 0 to 30 degree latitude band on either side of the equator moves in. This wind blows from the north and the south towards the equator. At the pole, the air is cooler than that at the latitude about 60 degrees. The warm air at this latitude rises up and the cold wind from the polar region rushes in to take its place. In this way, wind circulation is set up from the poles to the warmer latitude. Uneven heating of land and water. You have read about the sea breeze and the land breeze in chapter 4. In summer, near the equator, the land warms up faster and most of the time the temperature of the land is higher. On this place, most of the time the temperature is higher than that of the water in the ocean. The air over the land gets heated and rises. This causes the wind to blow from ocean towards land. These are monsoon winds. The thunderstorm and cyclone. Next point is thunderstorm and cyclone. Thunderstorm develop in hot, humid, tropical area like India very frequently. The rising temperature produces storm upward rising winds. These winds carry water droplet upward where they freeze and fall down again. The swift movement of the falling water droplets along with the rising air creates lightning and sound. It is this event that we call a thunderstorm. Now, how a thunderstorm become a cyclone? Before cloud formation, water takes up heat from the atmosphere to change into vapor. When water vapor changes back to liquid form as rain drop, this heat is released to the atmosphere. The heat released to the small atmosphere warm the all around. The air tends to rise and cause a drop in pressure. Moving air rushes in the center of the storm. Moving air rushes in the center of the storm. The cycle is repeated. This cycle is repeated. The chain of event end with formation of very low pressure system with very high speed wind revolving around it. It is this weather condition that we call a cyclone. Now, next point will be discussed in next video. Thank you.